Hi guys, welcome back to Crack Easy, the place to learn how to crack easy exams. You are with me, Abhisha. Hope you all are doing great. Today, I'm going to share detailed solution of K2005 questions on signal sense systems basics. Please do watch the session completely. Hope all set to get started. Here, the graphical representation of a discrete time sequence x of n is given. Another discrete time sequence y of n is defined in terms of x of n as x of n pi 2 minus 1 for n a1, 0 for n odd. In fact, we are asked to find out the graphical representation of y of n. Now, have a look at four options given. So first, what we are going to do is we are going to express x of n in sequence representation. In fact, in sequence representation, a discrete time signal is expressed as a sequence of numbers within a pair of set brackets. You can see the discrete time signal x of n is having non-zero value only at 5 time instants. At n equal to minus 2, it is 1 by 2. At n equal to minus 1, it is 1. At n equal to 0, it is 2. At n equal to 1, it is 1, and at n equal to 2, it is 1 by 2. So we can write x of n as a sequence of numbers like this: 1 by 2, 1, 2, 1, 1 by 2. The origin of x of n is indicated by this arrow symbol, which means the value of x of n at n equal to 0 is 2. In the question, y of n is given as x of n pi 2 minus 1 for n even, 0 for n odd. We are asked to find out the graphical representation of y of n, and for that, first we have to obtain value of y of n for different values of n. So let us do that. When we substitute n equal to 0, we get y of 0 as x of 0 by 2 minus 1, that is x of minus 1. What is the value of x of minus 1? That is value of x of n at n equal to minus 1, it is 1. So we get y of 0 as 1. And we can directly write y of 1 as 0, since it is given in the question that y of n is equal to 0 for n odd. Next, we substitute n equal to 2 and get y of 2 as x of 2 by 2 minus 1, that is x of 0. X of 0 is 2. After that, y of 3 can be directly equated to 0, since it is an odd number. And at n equal to 4, we get y of 4 as x of 1, that is equal to 1. And we can directly equate y of 5 to 0. Then we have n equal to 6, we get it as x of 3 minus 1, that is x of 2. X of 2 is already given in question as 1 by 2, so we get y of 6 as 1 by 2. And at n equal to 7, we have y of 7 is equal to 0, since it is an odd number. And at n equal to 8, we get y of 8 as x of 8 by 2 minus 1, that is x of 3, that is equal to 0. At n equal to minus 1, we can directly write y of minus 1 is equal to 0, since it is an odd number. And at n equal to minus 2, we have y of minus 2 is equal to x of minus 2 by 2 minus 1, that is equal to x of minus 2, which is given in question as 1 by 2. We can directly write y of minus 3 to 0, since it is an odd number. And we get y of minus 4 as x of minus 4 by 2 minus 1, that is equal to x of minus 3, that is equal to 0. Thus, we obtained all the elements of y of n. Based on that, we plot y of n here. The independent variable n is plotted along x-axis and the signal value along y-axis. You can see at n equal to minus 2, we have y of n 1 by 2. N equal to 0, it is 1. N equal to 2, it is 2. N equal to 4, it is 1. And at n equal to 6, it is 1 by 2. By comparing the options given, we get the answer as option A. Got it? Hope you all understood this problem perfectly. Let me now take you to next question. The Dirac delta function Taloft is defined as. Four options are given. In fact, this is a graphical representation of Dirac delta function Taloft. I hope you all know that it has zero amplitude everywhere except at t equal to zero. At t equal to zero, the amplitude is infinity such that the area under the curve is equal to 1. Thus, our answer is option D. Moving on to next question. The function x of t is shown in the figure. Even and odd parts of a unit step function u of t are respectively. This is our x of t. Option A, 1/2 x of t. Option B, -1/2 x of t. Option C, 1/2 x of t. And option D, -1/2 x of t. Let us first understand this question. Here we have a continuous time signal x of t. Its plot is given here. We are asked to find out even and odd part of unit step function u of t in terms of x of t. Got it? First of all, let me ask you something. Do you know how to find even and odd part of a continuous time signal? Suppose we have a continuous time signal g of t, then its even part is defined as g of t plus g of minus t by 2, and its odd part is defined as g of t minus g of minus t by 2. In fact, in the question we are asked to find out even and odd part of unit step function u of t. So what we need to do is we have to find u of t plus u of minus t by 2 and u of t minus u of minus t by 2. Let's do that. This is our unit step function. You can see it is having a constant value 1 from t equal to 0 to infinity, and it is 0 for t less than 0. When we perform time reversal on u of t, we get u of minus t. That is, u of minus t can be obtained by folding the signal u of t about t equal to 0. So we get u of t like this. It is having a constant value 1 for t equal to minus infinity to 0 and 0 for t greater than 0. Our next task is to perform addition of these two signals, u of t and u of minus t. The sum or addition of two continuous time signals can be obtained by adding the values at every instant. You can see for the range minus infinity to 0, u of t is 0 and u of minus t is 1. Correspondingly, we get the sum u of t plus u of minus t for the range minus infinity to 0 as 1. And for the range 0 to infinity, u of minus t is 0 and u of t is 1. Hence, we get the sum as 1 for 0 to infinity. Even part of u of t can be written as u of t plus u of minus t by 2. U of t plus u of minus t is already obtained. When we divide that sum signal by 2, we get a signal like this. You can see it is having a constant value 1/2 for t equal to minus infinity to infinity. Hence, it can be written as 1/2. Thus, we obtained the even part of u of t. What's our next task? Our next task is to obtain odd part, which is defined as u of t minus u of minus t by 2. This is our u of t, and u of minus t is already obtained like this. Now, we have to subtract u of minus t from u of t. Look at the time range minus infinity to 0. What's the value of u of t? It is 0. And what about u of minus t? It is 1. So when we subtract u of minus t from u of t, we get 0 minus 1. That is minus 1 for the range minus infinity to 0. On the other hand, for 0 to infinity, u of t is 1 and u of minus t is 0. Correspondingly, we get u of t minus u of minus t as 1 for the range 0 to infinity. Thus, we obtained u of t minus u of minus t here, which is having a value minus 1 for t less than 0 and 1 for t greater than 0. Our next task is to divide this signal by 2, and after performing division, we get a signal like this. which is having a constant amplitude 1 by 2 for t greater than 0 and minus 1 by 2 for t less than 0. So this is our odd part of u of t. When we compare this signal with x of t given in question, we get odd of u of t is equal to x of t by 2. Or our answer is option A. Got it? That's all about this session. Thanks for watching. Thank you.